commitment to ABC, and Dallas had been on for a couple of years on another network, and they didn't have anything like that. So we said, why don't we create a family that's so outrageous that this family will have all the problems, everything that nobody on television ever has.
Well, what do you want me for anyhow? You have a son. That's a natural line of succession. Let Stephen get married. Let him provide the royal heir. Give him the 70%.
I'm afraid Stephen is not going to work out.
Well, why? What's the matter with him? Low sperm count?
Mind your own business.
When Aaron read it, he started on page 8, he called, and he said, oh my God, this is going to be incredible. And we just had it in our head to do these things and to go in a place where we only dreamed about it. It wasn't about whining and crying and wanting to get another marriage or something. It was about fantasy, a fantasy that was accessible.
This is a decision that'll affect the rest of our lives. You can't make it on the flip of a coin.
I don't need a quarter to tell me that I love you. It's you. Do you love me?
I do, of course I do.
How much? Little? Lot? 40%? 65%? More than a hurricane? Less than a squall?
Oh, Blake, don't you see? It's not you. It's just that I can't get used to...
Go on. It won't hurt you. It's the money, isn't it?
That whole image of wealthy, wealthy people and, you know, and having all kinds of problems and being crazy was popular in the, you know, black and white films in the late 20s and 30s. It has the same appeal as tabloid literature. Because it's like, look, you know, they're all messed up too.
I don't think this was very discreet of you, Fallon.
Don't lecture me on discretion, Miss Hypocrite. You of all people. I'm not a child, Matthew. I'm a grown woman. But I love you, Crystal. God knows, but I will always love you, Crystal.
It's very iconic when you look at it. If you said, hey, tell me about the 80s, you know, you'll fly through your disco and you'll come upon Dynasty. They were completely dysfunctional. Well, show me a family that's functional. I mean, I'd like to be in that family.
Oh, you stay out of this. You're not part of this family.
I don't need Jeff to defend me, Fallon.
Tell me something, Crystal. Why did you come back that night? You left my father that afternoon. You were probably off with Matthew Blaisdell anyway.
Fallon!
You know what I think? I think you came back to pick his bones. This afternoon was a good start. Big lady at the board meeting. Gulping down that first bottle of power.
Now that is enough. What she did at that meeting was tremendous. I'm very proud of her for that.
Well, I'm not so sure she doesn't believe you did it. What do you believe, Crystal?
Now stop it! Damn it! My God, look at us! We were a family once.
People who remember the black and white 50s stuff can conjure up, you know, that whole perfect house, perfect family. You know, the definition of functional is sort of broad. I don't know a whole lot of people who came from functional families, and I certainly don't think this was one.
Why are you being so helpful to me? I certainly haven't won you over.
That's right, you haven't. But you see, if you embarrass yourself, and you embarrass my father, I don't want that to happen.
In Blake, we wanted a patriarch. I wanted a Blake, as it turns out, who was a little more sinister than John wanted. And to his credit, he made the characters strong and wise, also flawed.
That was plane shot down over Kansas.
Forgive my stupidity, Blake, but is that some kind of a joke?
It's a joke.
Then we decided we needed, of course, children who were going to disrupt his life.
The concept was that here is a man who is so successful in the business world, but his own personal life, with his kids, with his wife, he couldn't get a handle on. And that's where the drama came.
Because he won't talk to me.
Oh, you're lucky. And sell me into the harem of a sheik for 3 barrels of crude and a box of cigars.
We wanted to have a brother and sister that were close, but we wanted this outrageous girl that would, you know, have to do with an entire football team. You never knew where she was, and she'd drink champagne out of a cup. And she was wild and funny and bright.
I guess I had too much to drink.
You had two bourbons, tops. Is this how you showed me to do it, Jeff? You know, between the two of us, there wasn't any writing on that cigarette we smoked.
People were pitted against each other. They were scheming. I was resentful and nasty to my stepmother. There was tons of crazy stuff going on, all kinds of problems. And I, of course, people love that.
Tell Michael to pull over. I want to get out.
I'll have him take you back after we talk.
Michael, pull this damn thing over.
All right. But you haven't told me what you intend to do about this. Or is the line, I have a family, I have responsibilities?
You said it, so maybe that's the line.
Strange. Bizarre. I mean, you obviously don't believe in divorce, but adultery, that's just fine.
She had all the stuff that Blake needed. This is somebody she could never really have. She couldn't be the head of his company because he had his own sense of what women should do.
I expect, bright as you are, you'll end up running your father's company.
Not likely. See, there's an unwritten law at Denver Carrington. At the upper management level, there are no blacks, no Jews, no Eskimos, and no women.
Proudest thing for me, I think, is Stephen and the effect that he had in presenting the audience with a gay hero. We didn't play necessarily to his gayness. That's just what he happened to be, but mostly he was Blake's son. That was a bit of a problem for Blake.
Of course. I forgot. The American Psychiatric Association has decided that it's no longer a disease. That's too bad. I could have endowed a foundation. The Stephen Carrington Institute for the Treatment and Study of Faggotry.
When we first saw a lover that I had, I couldn't even really touch the guy. It wouldn't let me touch his hand, even on a table.
Ted, I want you to understand. And I want you to know that images and memories, I got them too. And they're inside of me. Deep inside.
Wouldn't let us have any physicality unless it was something in everyday life, something practical, like a handshake or a hug and saying goodbye, like, you know, guys do it. People thought I didn't want to play someone gay because I wasn't gay, and it wasn't the case at all. As a matter of fact, it was the opposite. It's hard to write years and years and years in the same character. Was he's gay or he's not gay. You can't be a slave to the censors.
I'm in love with a man. And you're married to a man you don't love. Now, you tell me something, Fallon. Which one is worse? Which one is more immoral?
What makes you think I don't love Jeff?
Come on, I can see the way you treat him. Jeff can't.
Well, does being gay also make you clairvoyant?
Crystal was actually everything that a man dreams of in terms of giving him comfort and understanding, at the same time standing up to him when it was necessary. But when things went wrong with the kids and everything, she was the moral compass.
He's your son, Blake. Your son opened up to you. He threw himself at you, at your mercy. And you cut him off again. How can you ever expect to be close to him?
Is it Stephen that you're so concerned about, or is it Matthew Blaisdell?
It's a rotten thing to say.
The networks considered her too old. She was like 35 or 6 at the time, which was infuriating to me.
There really weren't that many glamorous, beautiful, sexy women who were on television shows who were portrayed as glamorous and beautiful and sexy and had something to say, and that weren't just trophy wives. Women, they felt empowered by that.
I married Blake because I love him and because I want to make him happy. And I hope he feels the same about me. I'm not somebody's prize. I'm not a handful of oil leases. I'm not somebody's mineral rights. And I did not, as half the people in Colorado seem to believe, marry Blake Carrington because of his money.
That, my dear, was probably your first mistake, but we can deal with that.
We wanted a show where women could really express anger. Everything that a man is applauded for, women weren't. And I thought, wouldn't it be great to have a show where women could really be who they are and who could dream and could fantasize and could actually live the life they wanted with no limits.
I type 85 words a minute and she only types 60. So how come she gets the big house and the jewels and the furs? Sure, give me my own tennis court and a pro to teach me, and inside of 2 weeks I will be... I'm sorry, Crystal, I didn't mean it.
Hey, I understand.
John was older, but that worked okay. He had been doing Charlie's Angels for Aaron, and at first wasn't even considered for the role because of that. We sent him the script, and we had to redo the pilot. John was fabulous.
Mr. Carrington, you found out that I was seeing your daughter, and you had me worked over.
Did I?
Well, if that were the case, then one would hope that you learned a valuable lesson, one that in the long run you might even thank me for.
We did soften him. That was to John's credit. I mean, John had been on other series. He had a very good sense of what will go down with an audience. We didn't really want him mean or unlikable. And it was important to John, he felt. And sometimes he had to do tough things, but he wanted the people to like him.
Something happened between us the other day that was something that I'm very sorry about and deeply ashamed of. Something that I know hurt her very much, and something that could have damaged her faith in me and her love for me.
He's the anchor on which everything hinges. And you look at a lot of shows that play themselves out in a few weeks and you wonder what was wrong. They have no anchor, they have no center. And it's important that you have a center, I think, for a show. And he was the center, as Crystal was the moral compass. And together they formed the love that lived forever.
You know, there's something that I want from you, too, just as seriously. I want a child by you. And soon, very soon. Because, you know, neither one of us is getting any younger.
And I want to give you a child. But do you suppose we could just hang in there until after the Spanish omelet?
Mm-mm.
They all love their roles. They love their roles. Pamela Sue Martin, for the time that she was on, used to say it was like a Christmas package for her to open up the script every week. She loved biting the head off the cake in the pilot.
It was kind of outrageous. A chauffeur throwing me up against a tree and ordering me out of the car. It was really kind of wild and fun.
Hey, come on. I think I'm entitled to a few minutes with you.
Entitled? You're entitled to that dumb uniform. And whatever my father pays you to drive.
It really is a nighttime soap opera. It's based on conflict. And if there's not conflict, you'll invent conflict.
Is there something you want to have out with me, Fallon?
Crystal, what a melodramatic question. Have what out? If it's that sweet talk I ever heard between you and Matthew, I mean, it was a party. We all of us say things at parties. I mean, if I had been quoted after two sips of champagne, really, have what out?
I had no idea that it would become a worldwide favorite. The audience liked it. And when they tested the characters, those three or four characters were testing like in the 90s, and that's almost unheard of. And so I knew that we'd hit something.
When will I see you?
I don't know. I've got to get away somewhere where I can think.
Well, at least you can take your own car. Now, this is a very impressive gesture, but you don't have to go by public transportation, you know.
It's not my car. Look at the registration. It belongs to Denver Carrington, just like everything else around here.
The first season was somewhat a little bit experimental.
People really wanted to see what happens with wealthy people. Rich people cry, and they bleed too. They just bleed money. And you say, boy, you know, I always wondered what they do behind closed doors. It's not just about going home and making enough money to put food on the table.
You are all dispensable to me. My wife is not.
And the audience, they don't tell you how to do it or how to make it unpredictable, but they tell you what they like. The audience absolutely did not want to see the middle class.
Well, then you better get ready, because I don't like being married to a mental patient any more than you like being one.
They wanted to go over the moat into the mansion. They wanted to live that life.
I don't hate you. I love you.
What?
Nothing.
Matthew, look at me.
I guess I'll always love you.
When you came back, you said you didn't care for me anymore.
I know. I did what I thought was best for both of us at the time.
Am I supposed to be grateful to you for that? Who the hell gave you the right to make that decision for me? I'm not a child, Matthew. I'm a grown woman.
It's a great story. It was like the audience was tapping their fingers until you got to what they wanted to see. It became too much of a separate story.
Am I a bastard?
Hey, what kind of question is that?
There were no limits. We could, you know, get away with almost everything, and we did.
She loves me not. She loves me. She loves me not.
What are you doing?
Doing what?
Why are you doing that?
I thought we had some kind of an understanding.
None of it seems shocking to me. I grew up in the 60s and, you know, anything goes.
Hello, that's grass.
To be exact.
Well, suppose somebody sees it.
Well, don't worry, I've got enough for everybody.
Silent. You could get arrested for fooling around with that stuff.
I bought it from a starving seminary student, so you'll be supporting a good cause.
Fala. Scientific studies have proved it confuses the thought process. It absolutely destroys the memory.
So far, you don't have anything to remember. Well, we could work on that.
There's something about doing a show like this. Most of it is interior because there's secrets. Now, occasionally you have to have some air. This worked because it was enclosed in that mansion, and the mansion itself became a character. And that was a message from the audience.
Well, we kind of feel personally responsible for the Reagan years.
It's like a cocktail party on Wednesday nights on ABC.
I do think it's odd that it went all around the world, and I kind of shuddered to think that that's what people in other countries thought of Americans, because, you know, it was just this kind of crazy frame of reference.
I have a document here signed by Blake Carrington, which gives me the power to remove you. I hereby exercise that power. But don't think that just because Blake Carrington isn't here that I won't be keeping an eye on you. Every one of you.
This reflected the glitz and the glamour and the greed of the 80s. Greed is greed, power is power, anger is anger, fighting is fighting, so it's visual and larger than life, so it appeals like that.
Get your hands off my son.
Dad, we were...
I said get your hands off it.
He's not breathing. You've killed him.
They took what was popular, like Dallas or whatever, and they wrote something that was even better. It was a little more multidimensional than most of the genre, I think, and that's why it became so successful.
I know, that's what you've been saying all along. But did you lie the way Steven said you did?
I did. Can't you understand why? Doesn't Stephen? doesn't he?
Your father's right. You've lost your brother, Fallon.
Jeff, what am I gonna do?
It entertained people, because that's essentially the business that we're in.
Aren't you, in fact, a homophobe?
No. It was only in relation to my son that I felt any...
Homophobic! Homophobic enough to kill?
No!
Mr. Carrington, we have had direct, conflicting testimony in this trial from your own children! From your son and your daughter! And we've had very oblique testimony from you, sir. So there is no absolutely true way that we can recreate that instant before Ted Dinard died. But I ask you, sir, despite what you have told this court and this jury, isn't it true, sir, that in that last instant before his death, you wanted to see him dead? You, in fact, wanted to kill Ted Dinard? That you took full advantage when you pushed that young man, as your son has testified, as your own son has told this court and jury, to shove him just as violently as you could, to see him hit his head and to watch him die? Isn't that what you really wanted? Isn't that what you really intended, sir?
No! No, that's not true.
We would have marvelous times doing this. It was not like work. We would be screaming with laughter and encouraging each other to come up with more and more outrageous things. I love Dynasty. I have to confess, as much now as I did, you know, when we first thought of it. That's just the way I feel.
What's she doing here? What's going on?
My God, that's my mother.